Well, it's all mocked out and the water's all gone now. Don't want that to happen again, it's a nightmare. So this is the River Aire, which is part of the Saltaire area. In fact, that's some of the mills that Titus Salt built. He financed all this area for his workers. Quite revolutionary in his day. Roberts Park. It's big. And it was all put here by Titus Salt, the mill owner, for his workers. We've got lucky actually, we're here for the annual festival they have to remember Titus Salt's birthday. Going on this weekend, there's bands all day Saturday and all day Sunday. Amazing. Squirrel Nutkins hiding his nuts. And there's a statue of the great man himself. He must have been truly wealthy. Truly wealthy man, industrialist, who did immense work for his workers. It's one of those places you've got to see for yourself. You can't sort of get the scale of it. So this is the annual birthday celebrations of Titus Salt. A lot going on, live stage, beer tents, fast food stores, and it's not raining, which is good because it would spoil it if it was raining. Very good. That's the band just sitting up there, and the green man. Salt mills in the background there. There's a backdrop to this festival. It's impressive actually. If you're ever in the area at this time of year when they're doing it, come and have a look. It's good. Off to the bandstand. What a magnificent structure that is. Truly remarkable. So that's the history of that building, and it's now Saltaire United Reformed Church. So Titus Salt built that at a cost of £16,000 back in 1850s. I said, even if I did nearly sink the boat to get here. And this is Sir Thomas Salt's mausoleum. So that's part of the salt mill on the left hand side there. Stop the video and have a read if you're interested. As I say, it's one of these things you've really got to see to appreciate just how magnificent this hill is. And the festivities for the annual thing has already started. And that's a typical row of houses that he built for his workers. Built on a hillside, magnificent vistas it has too. Victoria Hall. Have a wedding function there now if you want. So this is Titus Street. And there's a street market going on and part of the annual festivities at the bottom of it. Well, there's some fabulous street food on offer here. Spoilt for choice. Wow, just look at that. Fabulous Indian street food. This is just one small section of it. It's too much to take. Used to have a police station here as well. RJ Bargy sells ice creams. So we're just leaving Saltaire. Been here a week actually. Two of those days because it was the aftermath of a hurricane in America that caused 2 days of horrific weather here as well. Rain and wind. Certainly not the days to be going out on a boat. The wind alone plays havoc. And as you can see, we're just going through the part of the canal that's got the old salt woolen mills either side. They are magnificent, this whole area of Saltaire. If you're ever this way, it's worth a look. It's really, really interesting. Nice sunny day. Autumn's in the air though. It's got that real sort of autumny nip in it today, but it's a beautiful clear sunny day at the moment. Let's see what the day brings. Heading off towards Skipton. The ice cream boat. RJ Bargy. So we're meeting a guy called Michael, because we've agreed to do these locks together, and he's already set this lock. That is him, is it? So you can see the water pouring in the front of this lock. This boat's 60 foot and the lock's 62, so we're going to get wet at the front. Hi Michael! Yeah!
See you later.
Yeah, I'm
sure we'll see you again.
Yeah.
Are you going up Five Rise today?
I am.
See you there.
Yeah.
This is an aqueduct and it goes over the River Aire. Hello. Rainbow's End Hotel Boat. Well, that was useful. We paired it with Michael, another boat owner, to do the first three locks after Saltaire. So we're on our way to the Bingley Five Rise. I think Michael's going to pair up with us, and hopefully there's some volunteers anyway. That's Michael up in front on the boat, just going around that bend.
It's Thursday for the others. Yeah, as long as...
Hello. So there's a queue of hire boats for these locks. Two of them are wide beams, so they go up on their own. I think we'll be here for a few hours actually.
So we're moored at the bottom of the Bingley Five Rise locks. It's basically three locks all together, and then another 200 or 300 yards up the canal, it's another five locks. And right by the side of the canal here is a really busy road. There goes a police car. And there's a bit of a queue. And there's only one volunteer lock keeper. So we might have a bit of a wait today. So this is the vista from the road bridge by the locks. It's nice. Shame about the traffic noise. And then that's panning round, the locks are just down there, look. And there's the boat down there on the left hand side, second one down. Drop on these locks at Bingley is seriously big. This is the bottom lock of the last three. And this one on its own is high up without the other two higher still. Swing bridge to open before you go out of the locks or in, as whatever the case may be. So Michael and I are going up the Bingley Five Rise locks. In actual fact, it's eight locks. There's three right at the very bottom, and then a couple of hundred yards further up the canal, the steep five staircase locks that raise you another 50 foot up. You can see from this the water pouring in the gate. So when we were coming down, the back of the boat was getting all that water over it, which filled the engine bay right up. Now the front of the boat is getting cascaded with water, but it's not so critical because there's no engine bay at the front for it to flood, so I'm not so worried about that. But there is literally only inches to spare in these locks with a 60 foot boat. And the gates are in such poor condition. Anyway, it's an experience. I'm going to put it on fast forward for the whole thing. It makes this video very long, but for my own memories as well, I've done it this way. Thanks for watching.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.